DLC dropped like 2-3 days ago, and I've been super busy. Just don't got on that. But we're gonna try out these DLCs and these this arcade, man. We'll try survival. Medium. God damn it. What? Why even give me the option? I don't get that. See what this is about. Then took like a million bajillion years just to get this DLC to drop, or any DLC for that matter. So let's see what kind of new stuff they gave us. Pretty thirsty for this fucking DLC to drop. Just checking and shit. So let's see. I'm gonna play all modes and just give them a fair and you know a fair amount of time. It doesn't crash on me. Wellington, I wrote it wrong, so I'll change that. It's a dangerous place for a downer like you, and it's only getting worse. You got to escape before you succumb to hunger, thirst, or fatigue, all of which prove fatal if not looked after. If you could only find hidden key cards, you might the gates between the islands, make it to the boat, rumored to be moored on the farthest one. Get out of the 5 power cells, you need the power, and you just might make it out of Wellington World. Your score is based on how long you survive, with a hefty bonus for skipping to the outside world. Make sure you check the note screen for more important details. You can feel your stomach growling already, so hop to it.
A rose of Gilead. Percy told me about these. They're good for wounds and things. Berries. They grow all over the Garden District, don't they? Well, I guess I can eat these till I run across a pub.
Choke him out.
Benefit of Mr. Kite. The rabbit got into the garden. The rabbit got into the garden.
Sounds like some sort of secret message.
Jesus. The thing with this is you just kill the whole map.
Oh man.
I thought this was just like a hide and seek kind of thing.
Shit.
How many feathers you got? Shit. Oh my god, I'm really scared. How the... Jesus. What is it that... Dress inappropriately.
Where are they now?
It's not you. It's me.
You better have something. Okay, I guess.
That'd be ironic. Die of thirst in England.
Where the hell am I supposed to go?
I think this might be the one Sally and me tried to blow up. I always wonder what happened to the letters. There was an awful lot of smoke.
over!
Can't we just agree to disagree?
That's a bit risky. Look what happened to Goldilocks.
This isn't your
He's got blood on his hands!
He's there!
There's no room for you!
Something out. No. Don't mind me. Just having a bit of a sit down.
do they bear them? I'll ask you that.
Hello.
You'd be amazed what people throw into the bins.
That sucked. in front of a fucking thing. Alright, well, let's try the other one. And, what was that called?
Thing of wrath, goddess, Achilles' anger, that brought so much sorrow to the Greeks.
Well, everything's gone pear-shaped, hasn't it? Wastrels running amok, plagues on the streets, and properties and citizens going off their joy right and left. And who's supposed to get it sorted? You are. Constable. That's bloody well who. Fortunately, headquarters issues a bounty on every rotten downer you settle down. Unfortunately, HQ can no longer provide you with Blackberry Joy for free. Cutbacks, you know, so try not to spend too much of your bounty on, at the shops. You don't want to become a downer yourself, do you? Do you?
Roll up the Magical Mystery Tour. Step right this way.
Jesus Lord. They're running low on joy. You're not careful, you could have done it. Joy, because it's library and move on. Oh, it's my joy, okay.
I'm off the clock now.
Try that shit again. You need... Okay, so... I guess for every... every motherfucker you beat down, you get points, and obviously, but like, how much money do you get? Doesn't tell me.
Sing in me, muse, of that man skilled in all ways of contending, and travel not far at all.
Right then, time to guard the sheep and hunt the wolf.
So I guess buying that the 25.
Heels up victory day.
Take this, be a lesson to you.
Marvelous.
John Constable.
Well, time for a little physical re-education. Bloody downers. Always making trouble.
That shit's hard. That bitch takes mad fucking... That bitch has mad life, yo. I've beaten the ever-living bejesus out of that bitch. And that bitch will not go down. And the fact that I gotta keep fucking keeping my high up with some money, and my fists are not doing it since they fucking thrown like fucking a bajillion fucking downers at me. The first one for me seems like it's the same thing, like playing the actual story. It's just, you know, just go around and try not to die. Obviously, it's the same basic, you know, like goal, not goals, but as a, you have to maintain that, like as you trying to beat the game, you're gonna maintain staying fed and hydrated and all that. It's like, this, I don't know, I feel like that's the same thing as a story mode. Is same shit, or maybe they just increase like getting dehydrated a lot faster, and but my food wasn't going down at all, like as much.
Sorry. Baby needs new shoes.
So Jesus.
Leave my friend alone!
Oh, what the... Oh shit, they just see me. Oh my god.
Better you than me.
I see you. You murder.
Needs must, I'm afraid. Don't go peaching on me to teach you, huh? Satisfying than undermining the other girl's confidence.
Nice clothes. Want to?
Ah!
Fuck me.
Gotta learn to give up some possessions. Or I'm not gonna win a race with a garden snail.
Benefit of Mr. Kite. The rabbit got into the garden.
Sounds like some sort of secret message. She killed my sisters, you know, to keep them from being scared. What about me being scared?
I appreciate the update that came with this game that took like so long to come out for some reason. This game came out like last year of... I think it was March? No. I think in May, I think. I'm not sure. But just to take all this time to offer these three modes. Obviously, there's more to come. You know? But the only one that's pretty fun is actually the Night Watch. But other than that, the updates are pretty stupid. They're not. It's like the first one's like the main game. It's like survive, okay. Hope you fucking do. Like, when you find a boat, fine. Like, the other one, you just... Well, spoiler alert, if anybody didn't, you know, beat the game. At the end, you just walk over, across on the bridge, and that's it. Game over. Well, not game over, but then you play as Sally, and then you play as Oliver. But other than that, like... That's it. There's nothing more.
Now it's time for I Hear You, the part of our show where Jack Worthing, that's me, answers your letters and questions about our life in Wellington Wells. And my first letter is from Mrs. Emily Cluley of Falkland Road. Dear Uncle Jack, I adore your show and thank you for answering my question. I have a big Victorian bed that my husband inherited from his grandmum, but most nights he crawls off to sleep in the small bedroom, in the small bed we have there. He promises that it's not because I snore, but he won't say why he does, and I'm not sure he even knows. He seems a little sad. What should I do? Dear Emily. May I call you Emily? Your letter is quite touching. You know the answer, don't you? You know the answer, don't you? Yes. You see, if he seems a little sad, there's only one possible answer. He's off his joy a bit, isn't he? Yeah. You must encourage him to take his pills, even if he seems a bit defiant. Take him to a doctor. There's no sense in sleeping in a rickety little bed in a small room when you can sleep in a proper English bed in a proper master bedroom. And quite frankly, even if you did snore, if he's taking his joy, then he should sleep soundly regardless. Just make sure he falls asleep before you do, and you both should be fine. Thank you for writing, Emily, and do keep me posted about you. Hello. Welcome to today's edition of Humor Hour, the show where you tell me jokes. Well, actually, I tell the jokes, but you send them in. And the first joke comes from Mr. Prentice Gibson of Claverton Town. Mr. Gibson says, what do you call three downers at the bottom of the sea? Not enough downers. Very good. We're starting off very strong today, aren't we? This one is from Bryony Ditton of Collier's Lane. What's the difference between a downer and a trampoline? You take off your shoes before you jump on a trampoline. How true! How very true! I mean, you don't want to damage a perfectly good trampoline, do you? Very good indeed. This is from Mrs. Jemima Hughes of Coronation Avenue. And her joke is, if you see a drowning downer, what do you throw him? I don't know, a brick? An anvil? Well, no, you can't very well throw an anvil, can you? What about a grenade? No. Who has grenades these days? Answer, another downer! I told you it was good.
Why don't we speak Latin?
Because it's 1946 and the Romans left Britain in 450 AD.
I can't hear you.
Why do you want to speak Latin?
You always know what each word means when it comes out. Impedimenta, the baggage. Impedimentorum, of the baggage. And impedimentis, to the baggage.
So it doesn't matter what all you say things?
Yes.
So long as you're talking about baggage.
What? No, Arthur, I'm talking about... Oh, fuck off.
Why are you learning Latin anyway? You still have trouble with English.
I can see it in my head. You make the words by sticking endings on them.
Well, that seems like an awful lot of effort.
When you learn German. When you learn...
That was shit.
Hmm.